Will we have contact lenses to help us see infrared light? This is light that we cannot see. We do not have the capability to see infrared light. And the first contact lenses were just made that can help us see just that. Let's focus in. There are a few animals that can see infrared light, like some snakes like pit vipers, or fish like salmon, or insects like mosquitoes. But us humans do not have the ability to see infrared light. There is a light visible spectrum that we can see between 400 and 700 nanometers. Anything below that can't see. That's usually where UV light is, ultraviolet light, high energy light. Anything above that includes infrared. We can kind of feel its heat, but we can't see it or detect it. That's also where microwaves and radio waves are. So how they developed these contacts, they took nanoparticles that do get excited when they're exposed to infrared light. They absorb this infrared light, it gets excited and emits a different wavelength of light, light that we can actually detect and see. Then they were able to infuse or implant these nanoparticles into a polymer plastic for contact lenses. Now, before all of this started, they actually tested these nanoparticles by injecting it into the retinas of mice and found that they are actually doing what they're supposed to do. Then they put it into a contact lens and sutured it onto the mouse eyeball. And then they were able to actually do tests to determine if the mouse was actually seeing the infrared light or if the contacts were actually working. They did brain scans on the mice to show that it actually had some activity when exposed to infrared light. They also were able to see that there was pupil constriction. So usually our pupils don't constrict in the dark unless we actually see light. And they were also able to prove that it was safe to be on an eyeball. So then they were able to do the human tests. So for the human trials, they put the contacts on and flashed infrared light, kind of like a Morse code test. And all the participants were able to see that flashing light as those nanoparticles converted it into visible light. And they were also able to determine which direction the light was coming from. Now, this is the part that I find interesting that a lot of people are not talking about. They were able to engineer different nanoparticles to emit a different color depending on the infrared wavelength that was shown. For example, if they showed the 980 nanometer wavelength, then they would be converted to a blue light that we could see. If it was 808, it would be green. If it was 1532, it would be red. Now, the reason why I find this interesting is because if they are able to engineer this, the one offshoot that they're thinking about is if they can do contact lenses with nanoparticles that with a certain wavelength where someone might be colorblind, it can convert it into a wavelength that they can actually see. And so this might be able to help people with color vision or see the different wavelengths without seeing the different wavelengths, if that makes sense. The other part that was really interesting is that when these participants were wearing the contact lenses, it actually worked better when their eyes were closed. Now, the reason for this is longer wavelengths, infrared light wavelengths, can actually penetrate the eyelid better than normal visible light. So when these participants had their eyes closed, it kind of got rid of all the other visible light spectrum, less interference, and they were able to focus exactly on the infrared light. Now, before our imagination goes wild, there are some limitations to this. They do find that wearing the contact lenses does scatter the light and cause the vision to be blurry. And so that is something that they're working on to try and clear up the vision. Right now, they actually have some wearable glasses that have these nanoparticles in there that convert the light, the infrared light, and then there's glasses kind of right behind it that's able to focus the light again so they could actually see what the pattern was and everything. So if they were able to show the light into letters or spell out a word, they could wear glasses and actually see the word that's coming from the infrared light. The other limitation is the only way that these are detecting infrared light is if it's coming from a very bright source, an LED light source. It doesn't detect very low light, meaning if you had the lights off and then you had some infrared light that's really subtle in the corner of the room, it's not detecting that. And so that's something that they are working on to try and to develop that. Now, the reason why this is kind of exciting is because the possible or potential uses you can use with this. A lot of things come to my mind as far as military applications, being able to send code that is not visible, such as Morse code or anything like that, sending code and then having someone be able to detect that. Or if you're in a low visible area such as rescue, if there's fog or anything like that, being able to see infrared light or a light source through fog or through the dark can be very helpful. I can see it being very helpful there. Or I can also see it being a good security measure with having encryption potential. And if they're able to actually develop it to be useful, this is going to be nice because people will be able to wear it without having a battery pack. You don't need to be charging this, kind of like those wearable helmets and goggles that can detect infrared light. This can be something that you just wear or even close your eyes and detect the infrared. So potential is huge. The real question is going to get there. And these are the types of videos I'm not really sure if I like making. For example, I did some videos on the AR or virtual reality contact lenses that were being developed out of scleral lenses. Super exciting stuff, looked very promising, and then they actually were bought up by a military grant, which is still promising, meaning that that type of technology is still being processed, but it's not something that civilians will see for years to come if it gets developed properly and gets used within the military. And so I'm afraid this might be something that is going to happen on a similar plane, where if it gets developed enough and people start seeing the potential of this, patents and certain technology might be gobbled up by military, taken away, used for those types of purposes, and down the road we'll kind of get the leftover scraps. I don't know. I'm exaggerating here, but that's just my worry, that it's going to be down the road. But they still are developing it. It's exciting news. And so I thought I just wanted to share. But what do you think? Is this going to go anywhere? Do you think it's going to be developed and we'll never see the light of day? Will you get a pair of infrared contact lenses if it ever becomes available to us? Let me know. Stay focused.